We see that in this material world, on the material platform, we don't know anyone that has real love, except for Gurudev, of course, except for the Vaishnavas. But we see that love is misplaced. We're looking for love in the wrong place, and we are really afraid to love, because whenever we love, we get disappointed. We're giving our love, we're looking for love in the wrong place, we're giving our love to the wrong person in temporary material relationships, so we're always disappointed. And in this material world, it's just, love is always disappointing. But then our scriptures tell us that there is another kind of love, there is real love, pure love, which is the love of the soul, for the super soul, the love of the real self, our real self, our spiritual self for Sri Krishna. So unless we connect with this love, we can never be really happy. We will just settle for second best, which is sense gratification in this world. But this never ever satisfies us. The more we try to enjoy, the more we suffer. So in this connection, I have to tell a story, because Ramachandra Prabhu is going to tell many stories, and just to put my little bit in. So once there was a very, very beautiful, young, qualified, strong, everything. There was one king, and he was the king at that time. Bharat Varsha was the kingdom of the whole world. So he was the king of the whole world. And when he was 25, he was married to an equally beautiful and qualified queen. And as a gesture, as a mark of his love for her, on the day of the wedding, he gave her a very, very, very expensive, very valuable necklace of diamonds. He gave it to her, and he put it on her neck, and he told her, "This is the gift of my heart, so always keep it with you and cherish it." But one little problem, that very beautiful queen, she didn't really love the king. She was in love with the commander-in-chief, who was also very beautiful and young. So, after a few days, or after a few weeks, she took the necklace, the diamond necklace, and gave it to the commander-in-chief, and told him, "As a gesture of my love for you, I would like you to have this invaluable necklace." So the commander-in-chief received it, but there's only one problem. He didn't really love the queen. He loved one very beautiful prostitute. So after a few days, he presented the necklace to the prostitute and told her, "Well, because I'm in love with you, I would like to give you something very valuable." And he gave the necklace to the prostitute. But the prostitute wasn't in love with the commander-in-chief. She loved the king. So after a few days, she brought the diamond necklace to the king and presented it to him. And when he saw this necklace, he was in absolute shock. And he nearly fainted. And then he looked at her and he said, "Where did you get this necklace?" Uh-oh, she realized she made a mistake. He said, "My dear king, I don't want to hurt your feelings. Now, I can't tell you. Well, if you don't tell me, I'll cut your head off." And the kings at that time, they were strong. They could do that. So then she had no choice. Said, "Your commander-in-chief gave it to me." So then the king called for the commander-in-chief and told him, "My friend, where did you get this necklace from?" And the commander-in-chief said, "My dear king, I'm really loyal to you, but I don't want to hurt your feelings. I don't think I should tell you. That if you tell me the truth, I won't harm you. But if you don't tell me the truth, if you try to lie, I will have your head." So then the commander-in-chief had no choice. And he said, "Your dear queen gave it to me." So then the king had a realization. A little realization. He realized there's no real love in this material world. And then he gave up his kingdom completely, and became renounced and became a very famous great devotee. So Gurudev says, the truth is that in this world no one has pure love for anyone else. And the love that we see, the love that we experience for our dear friends and relatives, mothers, fathers, sons and daughters, husbands and wives, lovers and beloveds, this is only a reflection of the real love of the spiritual world, a very pale reflection. And that reflection can never satisfy us. It's like a tree has a reflection in the water and we're trying to grab the reflection, but it's never really there, so it can never satisfy us. The only love that can satisfy us completely and give us the happiness that we're all hankering for is the pure love between the soul, between us and Krishna. And that love does not exist on a material platform, but Krishna manifests in this material world in a form of Shiva Gurudev, in a form of Shri Guru, who is a manifestation of love. And if we connect with him, we can connect with that pure love and maybe one day have a little taste of the real thing, the real love. And then we will never hunger again for material sense enjoyment. Vancha kalpataruvya sha kripa sindhuvya sha patitana bhavanevyo vaishnavyo namo. Bande aham.